Well, pain is the number one reason that people head to the doctor. According to the American Chronic Pain Association, 1 in 3 Americans lives with chronic pain every day. And another 23 million people have acute pain. While a number of treatments exist, many people lack the ability to access that care. And joining us now is Barby Ingle. She's the author and executive director of the Power of Pain Foundation. It's a foundation that she started after having a horrible accident. Nice to see you.
Thank you for having me.
Well, first of all, take us back to 2002. You were up in Washington. Your car was sitting still. You weren't even driving.
Right.
And yet you were hit from behind, and the driver was barely driving.
Right. He was going about 10 miles an hour.
Yeah.
And the doctor thought it was whiplash and a brachial plexus injury, and it turned out that it was a neurological condition called reflex sympathetic dystrophy.
Say that again, because a lot of people have never heard that before.
Okay, reflex sympathetic dystrophy.
Yeah, and for people who are at home and have severe pain after having a trauma, this is something they may really want to know about, and it's something doctors don't talk a lot about.
Doctors don't even, they actually don't even learn a lot about it in school, so it's difficult to treat and spot.
Yeah. Kind of give us a 101 on what that is.
Well, reflex is anything in your body that's reflexive. Mm-hmm. Your blinking, swallowing, your heartbeat, your intestines. Then sympathetic is your sympathetic nervous system, which also involves your limbic system, your ability to sleep. That type of thing is affected. Thinking, cognitive thinking is affected. And then dystrophy is the loss of muscle, bone type of things, coordination.
Yeah. This is, for people who may not know, Paula Abdul has the same exact thing. She was in a car accident, a plane crash. She's been in a lot of accidents. Yeah. We think that it has to be some kind of muscular thing, that we've been injured, and so there must be a way to heal it. But you really had to go all the way to Pennsylvania to find a cure.
Right. I actually did IV infusion therapy with a medication called ketamine. And it put my...
Which is a horse tranquilizer,
which is
it?
A horse tranquilizer, yeah. But they also use it for children, anesthetic for children's surgery. So,
yeah.
And they basically give you that, and it resets your system. It's like rebooting a computer, rebooting your brain, your pain system. And it also helps all the sympathetic things like discoloration, sweating, swelling.
Yeah. We have some video of you when you were in the hospital, and you can actually see on your back a lot of discoloration. Is that from the trauma? And is that your body kind of trying to figure out how to process that pain?
That is a symptom of the breakdown in the sympathetic nervous system.
Mm-hmm.
And some people have RSD just in one extremity. I ended up having it in full body.
Yeah.
And so my discoloration and swelling and sweating were head to toe.
It took several years, though, and hundreds of doctors, really, to be able to figure out what was going on with you.
Right.
You have written a book now to kind of help people understand RSD much better.
Absolutely. Not just RSD, but chronic pain, dealing with chronic pain in general.
Yeah.
It's for patients and caregivers. It tells how do you know what to do? What do you do after you're diagnosed, and tips and tricks for coping, things that you can do on a daily basis
to help you with,
or even how to travel.
Yeah.
There's tips on how to travel in there.
Okay. Let's go through some of the tips that you have for us, because the first one is speak up and know your pain.
Right. You're your own best advocate, and you have the right to timely and effective care.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're not getting that, make sure that you push yourself a little bit further and get to the right doctor.
Okay. You also say figure out your limits and simplify your life. That's really important, because when you're in pain, you can't do what you used to do.
Absolutely. And how I did that was I started a pain journal. I kept track of my pain levels in the morning and at night. And then I also wrote down what activities that I did that day, what made my pain better, what made my pain worse.
Mm-hmm.
And keeping this helped me simplify life, know which days I was doing better, what activities made me better, so that I could ease the pain and get through each day a little bit better.
And you've actually created what's become very helpful for people. It's a resource guide for people with pain. And inside here, there's all kinds of information. There's, you know, obviously places you can go for it. There's the journal you talked about, the pain journal, ways to document in your body where those things are happening. And you're giving these to people who are part of an organization that deals with pain?
Any support group in Arizona can go to our website and request that their support group be sent these, and we will send them for free.
Okay. And your last tip is reach out and seek out. What do you mean by that?
Reach out to the people in your life, your family, your friends. Have them help you with your activities of daily living, as well as attending doctor visits with you. And seek out is find the right doctor.
Yeah.
It took me 40 doctors to be diagnosed. I've seen over 100 healthcare professionals
wow.
in 8 years. And every doctor has their own specialty, so make sure that you get to a doctor that has studied your condition.
Very good. Barby, thanks for being with us and sharing
thank
your
you
story.
So much.
We appreciate it.
Well, do you hate licking those envelopes shut? Well, no worries, because with today's how-to smart tip, you won't have to worry about that anymore.